It's an offshoot to the Raptors coming to Toronto in 1995. It has created a kind of subculture or a belief that there is a need for a Canadian basketball league. Not one to compete with the National Basketball Association or with the quality of play there, but sort of a, for lack of a better term, a developmental league that might at some day spawn some players who could go on to greater riches in Europe or in the NBA.
Basically a league beyond U-Sport in many ways. When you think about the success of programs like Carleton and Ryerson and other leagues.
I'm not here to dispute it, but there is and has been for a few years a league, the NBLC, that's been in existence, what, 10 franchises? You're counting there, John?
I think it's 9 right now because they lost one. But yes.
And the one they lost is the Niagara River Lions, who are owned by a fellow named Richard Petko, who I guess got frustrated with the league and decided to form his own league. And that league is the Canadian Elite Basketball League, and their CEO will be or is Mike Morreale, who joins us on the telephone. Hello, Mike.
Hello, guys. How you doing?
We're great.
Excellent.
Are you guys ready to go?
We are ready to go come May 2019. We put in quite a bit of work, probably just over 2 years in the making now to the point we are at right now, and certainly well on our way to tip off in next May.
So how many teams will that be, Mike?
Well, we have 6 teams right now, spreading from BC, Saskatoon, Edmonton, Hamilton, Guelph, and Niagara, and we do have some interest for franchises in provinces we aren't currently, and I'm hopeful that one of them may be able to participate in the 2019 season, so we're still working on that.
What is the fundamental difference between the NBLC and your new league, the Canadian Elite Basketball League?
Well, there's a lot of differences. Number one, we're a FIBA league. We're going to work hand in hand with Canada Basketball. We're going to work to get regulated by FIBA. We're going to start by following all their rules and regulations. We're going to clear players through Canada Basketball. We're going to follow the referee standards set by Canada Basketball and FIBA. We're going to play in major spectator arenas across the country. We will be a spring and summer league, so we'll take advantage of that time to bring home some international Canadian players, develop new players, have a developmental roster spots. There's a numerous amount of things that make us different, but more often than, or I guess the biggest thing, in my opinion, is the way that we're governed and the way that we are corporately owned. So we have a single entity ownership that owns the league and owns all the 6 teams to start. And that was done purposely so we can actually have some runway to work with. In essence, we're a startup and we need some room to grow and run and make mistakes and get better. And you need money to do that. So that's a big plus into how we operate. And as we bring on new franchises, like I mentioned, those will be true franchises. But we'll hand over the playbook and say, here you go. We're taking care of merchandise. We're taking care of ticketing, scheduling, national partnerships, broadcasts, so on and so forth. So it's a turnkey entity to run.
As you aspire to be recognized by FIBA, then will you play international rules?
Yes. Yeah, it'll be 10-minute quarters. So we'll play all FIBA rules. All our courts will be FIBA aligned. We have gone out and either purchased those courts at all our facilities, or we have changed them over and converted them. We've gone into every municipality that we're in and haven't asked for a thing. We've walked in and said, we'll pay whatever the rates are to lease this place. We'll prove it to you. And, we'll put our best foot forward and let you kind of buy in.
So, Mike, when do you announce the teams and the cities? And when do you announce your management teams? I would assume you've hired general managers and coaches?
So the general manager coaches, some will come in the short term, some will come in early 2019. The teams have all been, the locations and the team names have all been launched. They've all been out there since for a couple months now. So we'll be playing in Abbotsford, which we'll call the Fraser Valley Bandits. We'll play in Saskatoon. That will be the Saskatchewan Rattlers, Edmonton Stingers, and then the Niagara River Lions, Hamilton Honey Badgers, and Guelph. The Guelph Nighthawks. And as far as our executive team, I think that's probably what I'm most proud of is that we brought on some really key executives in Canada, guys that have been involved in different levels of sport and different sports, like Lee Genier, who was with the Stamps and the Saskatchewan Rush for years, and John Lashway, who was with the Raptors and MLSE, and a bunch of other young people that we hope to groom into the next wave of sports executives.
Where do you get the players from?
Players will come from various places. A lot of them, our hope is that they'll be developed out of the U Sports program, out of graduating NCAA programs. We'd like to bring back Canadian players that have gone to play professionally overseas. And there's about 160 of them right now that unfortunately are not household names because they have to leave the country to do so. We will be working with U Sports and holding our U Sports Combine and Draft in March. We have a bunch of events around our scheduling. We'll hold the championship weekend at the end of the year to do like a mini almost Grey Cup festival, mini March Madness. And we're working every day on just getting better and better.
Greg, where are you going to get the money from? That's what I want to know. Forget about the players.
Well, Richard has been the type of guy who's, he's three parts super intelligent and one part crazy. So we've convinced him that this is the right thing to do, and he's bought in. We created a business plan going on 2 years ago and presented it to him, and he handed me the keys. He said, okay, let's get it done. I want to see it done at this high professional standard. We've encouraged talks with Canada Basketball. We've spoken to Michelle O'Keefe and Wayne Parrish and Glenn Grunwald, and we want to really create not only the best pro league in Canada, but the best pro league in North America. And we want to be recognized by FIBA as a sanctioned league for the FIBA Americas. That's really our goal. I believe that we will work hand in hand with Canada Basketball to develop talent and to showcase talent. I think that's the only way it can really get done properly.
Just for the purpose of clarity, will all the players on all the rosters have to be Canadian?
No. So we'll play with 10-man rosters and 2-man developmental squads. The 2-man developmental squad will be your up-and-coming Canadian player, maybe a local player coming out of high school potentially, can't get into college or university, or maybe is in that kind of gray area, doesn't know what to do with themselves but want to continue to play professionally. But the 6 out of the 10 roster spots, possibly 7, will be held for Canadian players. The other 3 or 4 will be for international players of U.S. descent, Turkish, Chinese, Australian, it doesn't matter. I'm leaning towards the 70% ratio because I want to see the Canadians on the floor. And it's important to our goals as a business and our goals as a league is to develop the Canadian talent and showcase it.
And what kind of salaries are you going to be able to offer?
It's a pretty big range. I would say we have the wherewithal to pay top dollar to get the people we want. We also have salaries that would be developmental in nature, where players will get paid a reasonable salary on a monthly basis. Our average salary on a per game basis will be either at or above the G League. So if you're familiar with their contracts and you look at their schedule, it's probably pretty easy to figure out on a per game basis what we're able to pay. So we want to set a high bar. We want to be able to allow players to go in between international leagues if they choose to go do that. We want them to be available for the national team. And we want to really, at one day compete for that FIBA Americas with a team from Canada.
Hey, Mike, would this not have happened if you had been given the commissioner's job or the president's job with the NBDL?
Well, I learned a lot from that that situation, going in there and kind of examining what that league was all about. And I obviously have the background with the CFL and the CFL Players Association. And, you just try and steal best practices. You don't try and reinvent the wheel. So we're some parts CFL, we're some parts WNBA, some parts MLS in how we operate. And I'm not sure I would have changed the mindset of the other league. Mm-hmm. In this particular scenario, we have a clean slate and we are going full bore to create exactly what we want at a high level without the interference of, individual teams having their own opinions at this point. We want to make sure we start at a high level and then other people can join and participate.
We wish you luck. Launch date is next spring, and we'll keep an eye on it. And we wish you good luck with it. Thanks a lot for joining us, Mike.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
Mike Morreale is the new CEO of the new Canadian Elite Basketball League.